The Martian tells the story of storm-facing, self-stapling, explosion-triggering, potato-farming, rover-driving, disco-dancing, lander-hacking, hexadecimal-speaking, Iron-Manning astronaut Mark Watney, and seems to be grounded in real-life, true-to-fact science. But how much of what we see is really possible? Let's size up The Martian in 11 elements. Number 1. The crew are forced to leave Mars because of a huge dust storm. This might be the biggest lie in the movie. There is absolutely no way a storm on Mars would ever cause this much damage, or even any damage really, other than moving some dust around. There just isn't a lot of atmosphere on Mars. Even the strongest winds would feel about as powerful as a gentle breeze on Earth. It's not enough to fly a kite in, let alone make a Matt Damon kebab from a flying piece of metal. Using his own, fertilizer, Watney is able to grow spuds in the soil. You'd need to let your droppings compost for several weeks and rinse the salt out of the Martian soil before planting. After that, you're in business. A bigger question is whether Watney could survive on a diet of mostly potatoes for 500 plus days. Watney produces water from hydrazine. The chemistry checks out, but it's also totally unnecessary. There's already water up there, frozen beneath the surface. It's just a matter of extracting it. And right before this movie premiered, NASA announced they'd even found liquid water on Mars. Use a radioisotope thermoelectric generator to heat the rover. RTGs are mainly used to generate power in remote locations, but they also give off plenty of heat, so your rover's gonna be nice and toasty. And while they do contain radioactive material, they're also very safe. In fact, NASA astronauts have flown with RTGs on all of the moon missions. Establish communications with Earth by hotwiring Pathfinder. Unlike everything else in the movie, Pathfinder is really on Mars right now, and has been there since 1997. Trouble is, after operating for a few months, it stopped working completely, and no one knows exactly why. It could just have a dead battery, like the movie says, or some other part could be damaged or broken. So, until Mark Watney goes up there, we probably won't find out.
Yes!
The position of the Hab, Watney, and Pathfinder can be mapped on this photo of the planet's surface. This might be a photograph of Mars, but it definitely does not show the actual spot on Mars where Pathfinder landed, or where the Hab and Watney are supposed to be. It's just a random picture that this cafeteria guy is really attached to.
Hey, come on, man, what are you
doing? It's alright.
A breach in the airlock sends Watney flying. Decompression is possible, but it wouldn't work like this or be nearly this powerful. For starters, air would be flowing out, not in. Like everything else in the Hab, Watney would be sucked toward the opening, not thrown away from it, and there's just not enough force involved to lift Watney off the ground. Patch a hole in your helmet using only tape. Is there anything duct tape can't do? The hardest part here would be ripping the tape with those awkward astronaut gloves. Potato plants die when exposed to the air? Average temperature on Mars is minus 60 Celsius, minus 80 Fahrenheit, a lot colder than it gets in Idaho. Survive a space launch in an open air capsule. The atmosphere on the surface of Mars is already very thin, which means by the time you're going fast enough to need protection, you're past most of the air anyway. Watney cuts his glove and Iron Mans his way to rescue. This one's hard to say. It would be really, really tricky to control the direction you fly, and you'd need a very precise cut and a lot of oxygen moving super fast to create enough thrust to overcome the 12 meters per second you need to meet up with Jessica Chastain in the middle of space.
I got it!
Final scores for The Martian. How scientifically accurate is this movie? Very accurate. Most of what we see is real and possible, though a few parts are completely made up. There are other huge challenges to Watney's mission, like solar radiation and microgravity, but the movie ignores these problems, so we will too. How does this movie look and feel from a production standpoint? Good, but not great. The visual effects on Mars are awesome, but zero gravity stuff looks terrible. You can easily see where the actors were suspended by cables, and their movement between sections looks really off. You can't just magically change directions. How does this movie rate for entertainment value? Awesome. It's a fun story and a great ride. There's a good balance of humor and science, even if Watney overcomes one too many obstacles for the film to feel like a completely plausible story. So it's a pretty accurate movie, it has some beautiful visuals, and it's really fun to watch, even though we're still a long, long ways from a real mission to Mars. Sorry, Watney. How did you like The Martian? What did you think of our review? Could you live on Mars for 500 days or eat potatoes for every meal? Finally, what movie should we fact check next? Tell us in the comments section below. Thank you for watching, and remember,
I'm a botanist.